Afternoon all, and welcome to DJ Lab session number 39. Yeah! Every Friday at 4 p.m, we love to showcase some of the world's best and freshest DJs just to warm you lot up for the weekend's antics ahead. This week it is Aus Music vs Simple. We have Will Soul, yeah. Dusky, yeah. And Midland. So if you have... So if you have any questions for the boys, be sure to get them in via the chat box because we'll be having a chat with them after. And of course, remember to subscribe to Mix Mag TV. Yeah. All right. Right then, Mr. Midland, let's take it away. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. We'll be right back. so silly of me to be afraid of what isn't there. So I took the covers off of my head. Yeah.
Be loving to be so like I am. Like I am. Like a hand. is Detroit. That's where men are last. We're keeping it clean, we're keeping it small. We'll be right back.
for your body.
Boiling.
Yeah.
Big. Yeah! Ow! Louder! Massive props, boys. Wicked set. Get your asses round here. Oh, it's all right. It's all good. Big shout out to Midland, who's chipped off away to go to Germany. I think he's playing with Kyle Hall this evening. Massive props to Will as well. That was awesome. We've got a few questions from the chat box. Okay, so firstly, it's kind of like a bit of a standard one, but some of the producers that have influenced your sound.
Oh, that's a tricky one. So many. I don't know, we started doing drum and bass, so there's a lot of people from that kind of thing, like Fotech, someone who like recently we've kind of like exploring a lot of his back catalogue and stuff.
It's ridiculous, he's got so many tunes.
Yeah. But then like we listen to a lot of Gary's, like MJ Cole, obviously. Too many to name.
Yeah, a lot of jazz and soul stuff as well. Like, I listen to a lot of other music outside of dance music, so yeah. That's, you know, like...
You can get in William, it's fine.
Can't listen to no, 100%.
Cool, and same question to you. People are saying some of the producers that have influenced your sound, really. And
who are the producers?
Yeah, just a few producers, few artists. I know it's a $1 million question, but...
Well, I mean, an artist that I've sampled a lot is Teddy Pendergrass. God rest his soul.
Already gets him, already won.
Exactly. But classic. I mean, God, there's so many. I guess a lot of the cliched, but a lot of the sort of the Carl Craigs and the classic Detroit guys that are still going have kept it really sort of fresh and continue to do so. They're still doing it for me.
Cool. So next week you're playing at Motion, right? With
yes.
Dirty Bird guys. Someone's asked how much forward are you looking to that? What's the best thing about that?
I love Bristol. It's about 40 minutes from where I live, so lots of friends and family. And the Emotion guys have really got it spot on. It's a super party.
Yeah, no, I think I'm going to Future Boogie and Moody Man and Kerry Chandler, so I think that should be a smasher. Yeah, no, I'm looking forward to that. That would be cool. Now to all of you, how long have you been producing each?
Too long, probably since I was about 15.
I thought you were going to be like since I was about 7 then.
No, not producing. They didn't have like production software when I was that age, but like we just started on the first few versions of Logic. So yeah, when I was around 15, so a long time now, I'm 27 now.
Decent.
Yeah.
A little bit longer than that, just because I'm older than that.
Yeah.
Probably best part of 12, 13 years now.
Cool. And who got you guys into it? Who's the one that kind of shoved you in towards the decks?
I think it was like a lot of me and my mates were DJing, so it was a kind of natural progression into making music. Like a lot of my mates were experimenting with making music, so that's how I got into it really.
Sweet. All right, cool. That's pretty much wrapped up today's DJ Lab session. Shout out again. Now stay tuned because the guys from Corrupt FM are going to show you how to lay it down just like these wonderful gentlemen here. Have a big weekend and we'll see you lot next week.
Hello, my name is MC Sniper, and I'd like to welcome you to the first instalment of 4 instalments from myself and the Corrupt FM community. These how-to tutorials will provide you with a detailed guide to working your way up in the music industry. Well, not too high up though, because if we could change that bit, because we're already at the top, and it's going to be pretty impossible to... Welcome to Sniper's Guide 2.
How to DJ.
Featuring DJ Beats. Lesson 1.
How to DJ.
Sweet. So what we're going to do is talk you through Sniper's Guide to DJing.
So first step into becoming a DJ, you will need equipment. These are Technic 1200s, I believe, 1200s. They're dead stock now.
Dead stock means they're not in. You can't buy them anymore. Probably look at in a loot or something. You still.
Yeah, you can probably still pick them up. Yeah. Decent DJ mixer. Can't really stress how important that is.
Very important.
That's that's what you do. Yeah. That's what you do. The magic.
You won't be able to do it without a mixer. So.
Nah, you'll be pretty much, yeah. Headphones. Good headphones, you just go through them, straight through them.
Substandard pair of headphones, go straight through them, goes through the jack, into the mixer, out into your ears.
Yeah. Slip mats to stop the records from scratching.
Show the mats though.
Sheepskin.
Sheepskin provides for better
cushioning for the records.
Vinyl.
Tunes. So now you just need some tunes. Steve's, please bring the records.
Steve's, bring the records.
Put the records wherever you want, mate.
Hello?
Wherever you want, mate.
Just anywhere?
Yeah, why not?
Classic mistake,
you see.
He's put in a place that's non-aerodynamic for the bag reach.
Yeah,
so
right.
Now we're going to show you how it should be done. Steve?
I'm therefore right-handed.
Yep, so where would you want it?
I need the forward motion.
You'd want it there?
Down, flick through the records, pull one out.
Just down.
Right.
All right, I'll show you how you do that. So, down.
Straight away then, you see?
It's out. What you do, take it out. Be careful with the records. All right.
You put it on.
Put this underneath the corresponding deck. So you know where it goes, because nothing is worse than a vinyl without a sleeve.
That's what I do as well, the same.
Yeah, sit down, Steve, for a minute, mate. And then what you want to do, because you mix them into two, you're mixing two tunes together, that's the whole art of DJing. You then want to just chuck that on there. You're good to go.
Yeah, two, sorry. Today we've gone for the Decoy Dub Plate Specials, which is in-house production, so.
Decoy Production.
Some of the best music out, isn't it?
Available in all good shops, everywhere that sells records. Decoy
right.
Productions.
That's because we couldn't get rights.
Nah,
that's
because
it's fine.
That's fine. They're better anyway. These ones.
Yeah. Slang.
Right.
What are they? 1200s.
Yeah, 1200s, bro.
I ain't seen them in years, dead stock. I've got 1210s myself, but.
Yeah, 1210s?
Yeah.
Yeah, six. 1210s are six.
Laters.
Thank you.
See that? Classic situation. DJ Beats approaches a club, steps in, sees a DJ mixing, approaches him to show he is someone. He's left glowing. He mentioned the slang of what this is called. He showed him that he's got better equipment, throws down the bag off the right shoulder, and then walks off. He's left in a daze, amazed. Now in his mind, the Stark Glass DJ Beats. A message to any rival, MC or DJ. Slang.
Appearance.
Right, what you got here is the prototype of what a DJ should look like. It's by DJ Beats. Introduce yourself.
DJ Beats.
What we got here is the cap. Makes the head look bigger, stronger. Always, can't get too close to him. You got the brim there, yeah? You got the headphones. What do you notice though? Only on one ear, innit? Show him.
One ear.
Right. You got the jacket. Look at that. Does it look like a DJ to you? Broad shoulders, always towering over the deck, showing people who's in charge. When he's on the decks, he's in charge of the whole rave. Well, I'm in charge of the whole rave, but he's number two. And that's also very important. You got a record bag. Also very important, because how are you going to take... Just put it down. How are you going to take records to a rave with no bag? That's insane. Also, what we got here? Skunk. Amnesia Haze.
Tangerine Dream.
Wow, both sativas, so.
Yeah.
Always keep inspired. One of the main rules.
DJing.
make it like that?
Well, what we got here? Nothing by the looks of it. DJ, could have fooled me. Yeah. Where's the hat? See that? No protection on the top. Weak instantly. Headphones. Where are your headphones? Yeah, they're there. They're meant to be in your head, aren't they? Yeah? One ear out. Look at the shoulders for a start. They're like women's shoulders. Yeah, that little jacket. Yeah? Slides straight off. No shoulder emphasis. But there's something we could do about this. Beats, get the jacket. Now look at that. This is how you should do it, yeah? Look how he looks. Looks good, doesn't he?
Ministry.
Actually, no, he doesn't look good. Can we change that? Because I just realised he looks...
Yeah, it looks weird, doesn't
it? He still looks exactly the same, but a bit worse.
Yeah, we need to give him something that makes him look a bit smaller.
It's just, he's too tall. He's strange looking.
The set.
This is a sort of breakdown of how I would do a set. So get your two tunes you want to start off with ready, which mine are. And then you can either do a scratch intro, and they love that in Japan, they go nuts for the scratching. And then you just start. Or, what Sniper likes, is a little ragga scratch.
Yeah, keep that for, ragga scratch, yeah? See, that goes well with the ragga raps, which we'll be showing you about in the next episode, innit? So just keep that on.
Yeah. I know it's now in time because of the... I got it, sounded good. Okay. Teasing. Nuts. Cut the bass out for effect for the ravers, and then you want to bring it in, ease it in. Perfect. Then what I'll do to fade it out, I'll then probably do a little rewind out. So, one, two, three.
Yeah, right, but don't leave the rewind for my set, because I have to, on the how-to, yeah, MC, that's where we're doing the rewinding, yeah? So don't do it here, because that's a part of what the MC commands the DJ to do, yeah?
Yeah.
It's just getting, you're rinsing it out now.
There are several types of
rewind. You're rinsing it out now.
There's one rewind where do it into the mix.
Oh, just wait for my one, because the MC one's probably going to be better anyway. We've been doing this for time.
Should I mix another one or should we cut? Thank you for watching, and make sure you tune in next time to the next instalment of the Corrupt FM How To Guide, where MC Sniper will be teaching you everything you need to know about being an MC successfully.
Hello, my name is MC Sniper, and I'd like to welcome you to the first instalment of four instalments for myself.